Welcome back, mineralogy fans. Sulfur may be unlucky 13th most common in the crust, but in the oceans it accumulates, and after sodium and chloride, sulfate is the most abundant dissolved solid in the surface oceans. So when ocean water evaporates, it first drops out some salt, which we will meet later in the halide minerals, but then drops out gypsum, followed by anhydrite, both being sulfate minerals. Gypsum has a vitreous, pearly, or even dull or sugary luster, and the color can vary, though gray to white is most common. The streak is colorless, and it has a hardness of 2, which is very diagnostic, as it is one of the few minerals you can easily scratch with your fingernail. Gypsum also feels a bit light, with a specific gravity of only 2.3. Though some massive varieties show no cleavage, we typically see one perfect direction of cleavage and two fair to pretty good directions of cleavage not at 90 degrees, which tend to produce these thin, rhombic plates of gypsum. We see from the formula that gypsum is a calcium sulfate with water loosely bound to the structure, which is indicated by the dot before the H2O. If you were to heat gypsum, as a friend of mine did when he stuck the tip of this selenite gypsum crystal into the fire one night at a party at my house, you would drive off the bound water and get just calcium sulfate, which is known as anhydrite, which not only forms from heated gypsum, but is also the last mineral to commonly evaporate out of seawater. It has a vitreous, pearly or dull luster, a white streak, and is usually white in color, though colorless, light blue or violet or gray are possible. It can easily be distinguished from gypsum, as its hardness increases to 3.5, so a penny will leave a scratch, but not your fingernail. Anhydrite also has a higher specific gravity of 2.97, but like gypsum, has three directions of cleavage, closer to right angles, to make more cubic fragments than gypsum. With both gypsum and anhydrite being evaporite minerals, meaning they precipitate out of evaporating seawater, they are most commonly associated with shorelines and shallow seas with warm, dry climatic conditions. Being so similar in genesis and chemistry, their uses are very similar. Both can be crushed up and used as calcium fertilizer, but anhydrite has more calcium per ton due to having no water included. Gypsum is actually 21% water by weight. Both gypsum and anhydrite are used to make drywall, plaster of Paris, and for controlling the rate of hardening in cement. Satin spar gypsum can be beautiful, especially when they become enormous cave-filling crystals like those in the Nayaka Cave or Cave of the Crystals in Mexico. Though beautiful, the hardness of 2 makes them have limited value as gemstones, but can be a pretty display mineral when handled with care. Dave, stop putting my gypsum in the fire. Another common and useful sulfate is barite, which is a barium sulfate. The name of the element barium comes from barite, which gets its name from the Greek baris, which means heavy. Barite may only have a hardness of 2.5 to 3, but it is one of the few minerals with a specific gravity over 4, coming in at 4.5. It has three directions of perfect cleavage at right angles to produce cubes. And really, those values of hardness, specific gravity, and cleavage are about all you have to test to identify a barite. It is usually clear to white, but it can be light colors of blue, yellow, red, or green. It forms in cracks of limestone or dolomite, or sometimes at the soil-bedrock interface. And when it precipitates as a cement in sandstones, it can make the beautiful barite roses we see in rock shops, though some of these are gypsum roses. Barite is mined for the barium it contains, which is used to increase the density of drilling mud so it can drain down the pipe to cool it and come back floating rock chips cut by the drill bit up to the surface. Barium from barite is used as a paint pigment or a heavy filler in various paper, glass, ceramics, rubber, or we use it for X-ray shielding, sound reduction, corrosion resistance. The uses are staggering. But one of the most notable is the barium drink many of us have enjoyed or will enjoy when we get an X-ray of our digestive system. The heavy barium milkshake coats the walls of our esophagus and stomach so the X-rays can get a good image of the system. Or you don't have to drink it, but you get it injected as an enema to form similar images of the colon. So if barium is a heavy metal, why aren't we worried about poisoning ourselves with a barium milkshake. Well, barium is not soluble in water, which keeps it from being taken up into the body, and thus it has no toxic risk. But before you start chowing down on barite, be sure it's not the next mineral, celestite. Barite has the same crystal shape as celestite. We say they're isomorphous, with the same crystal pattern but different chemistry, and so you can get a single crystal going from barite to celestite. Celestite is strontium sulfate. You don't want to be eating strontium. It's less dense than barite at 3.95. The transparency often displayed in celestite makes them a beautiful mineral, though color can vary as usual. The pale blue is most common and rather preferred by collectors. Other than value as a display mineral, celestite is the primary ore for strontium. There is strontium in fluorescent lights, and it is used in glass, ceramics, some medicines, and as a paint pigment again. Used in fireworks, strontium compounds produce the red colors we see, and so out of the blue celestite, you can get the red of pyrotechnics. The hanksite we met at the end of the carbonate minerals is here again to remind us that our mineral groups are placeholders and that nature is not concerned with our boxes and will slip out and allow hanksite to stand with one chemical foot in carbonates and the other here in the sulfates. This crazy mixing is partly due to the fact that ocean water is a dilute solution of just about everything, so the variations involving the sulfate or carbonate molecule are astounding. What the ocean can do with a sulfur atom stripped of oxygen is just as astounding and will be met in our next episode on the sulfide minerals. I'll end a day with as many sulfates as I can name in our closing moments. Sulfate minerals such as zincosite, vanthophyte, iavapite, zocomacatlite, spelled with an X, dancite, alunite, antlerite, nabucuite, beaverite, nabokite, chiluite, pseudo-grand-reefite, morehouseite, mallardite, ferrohexahydrite, spangolite, chelyabinskite, steverustite, ashamite, mendozite.